Hey everyone, we got good news. Fannie Mae has came out with some new rules to help you use your rental payments as part of the decision making in getting a loan. So when you apply for a loan, right, they're gonna look at your credit history, they're gonna look at all sorts of things, how much money you make, all that kind of stuff to see if you determine if you can get a loan. But the biggest thing is a lot of first-time home buyers maybe don't have a lot of credit. And so they have rental payments that, you know, they've been paying, but unfortunately less than 5% of people have their rental payments showing up on their actual credit bureau. So they're not getting credit for their on-time payments for their rent as a tenant. So the new rules starting September 18th, 2021, Fannie Mae is gonna take those into account as part of their desktop underwriting. So desktop underwriting is basically when your lender puts in all the information about you to help you get qualified for a loan, and put in your credit and how much money you make and all that kind of stuff. That system is going to look at your bank account, and whether you wrote for your rent via check or via their online portal, if they see consistent rental payments on your bank statements, those will count towards helping you get approval through their desktop underwriting program. So when a lender enters that information in, it comes back approved, eligible, or declined. The computer kind of takes all that information and decides initially if they will be able to approve the loan for you. And so what's exciting is all the benefits go to the potential buyer, because if you have the potential, if you have the rent income coming in and it's consistent, you're gonna get credit for it. But what's cool is that if for some reason you're inconsistent in paying your rent or missed monthly payments, that's actually not gonna count negative against you. So you only get the upside of this, which is really cool. And there's been a study that's found that 17%, they did a study that if people use these rent equation into things, that 17% more people would have been approved eligible via the desktop underwriting. So that's a lot of people who may be able to qualify for a loan now with this one simple change. So it's super exciting. This is brand new. It starts in the next week or two here. So if you have any questions on it, thinking about buying a house yourself, let me know, okay? Also too, something a side note, I'm in real estate. I deal with all things real estate. We have lots of people and vendors that we work with, whether it be roofers or handyman or people who do tile, flooring, whatever it is, we have a lot of those people. And I wanna share with you someone, if you do have any interest, because everybody has to buy power, and if you own your house, you're buying power from, chances are, SDG&E. And so I have a good friend who I've known for years, who's a military veteran, served in the Marines, good friend of mine. He has a company regarding solar. So if you want to save any money, most people do, saving money is really good. They can save people anywhere from zero, and obviously it wouldn't work for you, but all the way up to like 65% of what your electric bill is, okay? So if you have any interest in just having a conversation, a good friend of mine, a veteran, military veteran-owned company, and I'd love to make the introduction. If you're thinking about wanting to save a little money on solar, let me know, just shoot me a reply back, and I'd be more than happy to make that introduction to you. So anyways, if you have any questions regarding anything real estate, questions about the Fannie Mae and the new rules on that, let me know. If you want me to make an introduction to my buddy who's a veteran regarding solar, save some money, let me know as well. Thank you so much for watching this video. I'm Kimo Quants with the Kimo Quants Group. Have a great day.